Joseph Smith one time said a long pull, a strong pull, and a pull all together when he wrote about unity. Men have observed birds for centuries attempting to discover the secret of flight. An airplane is able to ascend upward due to the Bernoulli principle. That precept explains that the faster air is moving, the lower pressure it exerts. Airplane wings are designed so that the air moves quickly over the top and more slowly on the bottom, thus allowing the air on the bottom to utilize enough pressure upwards to counteract gravity and the pressure on top of the wing. We've learned a great deal observing birds and our technological advancements as humans. However, there are greater lessons yet to be learned. Take the geese, for example. These are truly amazing winged creatures. Dr. Robert McNesh, a biology teacher who had been intrigued with observing geese, is credited with this saying, "It is a fact that in the right formation, the lifting power of many wings can achieve twice the distance of any bird flying alone." As each goose flaps its wings, it creates uplift for the birds that follow. By flying in a V formation, the whole flock adds 71% greater flying range than if each bird flew alone. Similarly, people who share a common vision can get where they're going more quickly and more easily because they are traveling on the thrust of one another. In the restoration, we need to be moving more quickly and more easily together in declaring our testimony than the criticism coming from our detractors, enabling the saints to gain a lift by offsetting the pressure against the latter-day work. We as independent churches of the restoration have been flying solo for nearly 200 years and have yet to fulfill our divine mission as we gaze towards the destination at Zion's borderline. We have been given the promise, and blessed are they who seek to bring forth my Zion at that day, for they shall have the gift and the power of the Holy Ghost. If we earnestly desire to bring forth and establish the cause of Zion, we will become possessors of the gift and power of the Holy Ghost. The acquisition of this promised power will both galvanize and inspire the scattered of the restoration to fly above the storm of censure and scorn. When we become yoked together, these same winds which have blown against the scattered of the restoration will bring a change in our weather patterns. Atmospheric pressure at the surface of the earth is greater than its surrounding environment. These high pressure systems are associated with clear skies and calm weather. They are greater than our traditional boundaries. These winds will deliver a sweet warm breeze, causing the dark rainy clouds over the restoration to dissipate, bringing a clearer forecast than has been seen over the last 150 years. Dialogue, discussion, prayer, and fellowship are necessary for any two people to become one. As believers in the restored gospel, we have much to visit about. We're all recipients of a rich legacy which needs to be shared to strengthen each other. May our hope become enlivened as we see the arm of the Lord moving to bind us together, that we might begin flying in a V formation. The psalmist wrote, "Behold how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity."